Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to use a 3D tracker in Adobe After Effects to achieve this effect. Okay, so we got our clip. It's a drone footage of the house. So let's create a new composition from it. And at the beginning, let's go to a tracker. If you don't see it, just go window tracker. And we've selected our layer, click track camera. So now it's gonna take a little time. I always like to expand our advanced and click detail analysis. It's going to take a little longer, but it's going to, I would say, analyze our clip more detailed. So let's just wait for now. As you can see, a 3D camera tracker created a lot of points. You can attach everything to these points. You see this surface changing a lot because it shows how you can attach something to this point. If you look closer, these points are attached to specific places in our footage. For example, look at this one, green cross. It stays at this window through the whole footage. So if I'm going to attach everything to that point, to the single point, our layer will be attached to this point, but I can select, for example, few like that. So it's going to create me the surface like this, and I can put a layer on top of this surface. So let's go find the best place to attach our text on the roof. So I think it's going to be that one. So right now I'm going to right click on my mouse and press create text and camera. You can also create a solid and the camera, but it's going to be a next video. So let's create text and camera. Right now we have a text. It's a random text saying text. Also, a 3D tracker camera layer was created on our timeline, so let's not delete it, but we are going to use our text. So let's just see how the text lays in the whole video. Okay, right now I can say the text is attached to these points, it's moving with the house. So let's fix the position and the rotation and the angle of our text. Right now, let's double click and change it. Let's leave it like that. And right now, let's open rotation and position. And let's fix our text. I think it's okay. It looks like it stays on the edge of the roof. Let's watch the video. Yeah, I think that's okay. So right now I'm going to animate our text with X rotation. Let's move it here. So right now it's gonna like rise up. I'm gonna press F9 to ease out it, push it a little forward, and open our transparency, our opacity, press U to see everything, and press 0 here, and also, so it's gonna start like that. Okay, it looks very good, but I want to make this text a little glowing. So I'm gonna add effect glow. So let's just adjust everything. Check to alpha channel. Okay, I think that it's okay. Let's just see it again. It looks very good. And at the end, I want to my text disappear. So I'm going to show you a little trick. So you just add a Gaussian blur on our clip. Move a little forward and push like 116, and also opacity. Put the keyframe here. Press U to see where are the keyframes, and zero, and also easy ease. And I want to add a little flickering effect to our text. So I'll just click with Alt option on the Mac on our glow radius and glow intensity. It opens me our expressions. So I just going to write here wiggle 1 and 4. So it means our glow radius 1 time per second going to change its value for 4. And I want the same for our glow intensity. So I want to just add a little animation to our text. When it rises up, it takes a little bouncy effect. So the best way to achieve that, you can keyframe like a little more, a little less, a little more, or you can use a Motion Tools plugin. Just select our keyframes for rotation, this one, and click elastic. So it's going to open here. I'm going to here and 10, even a little more. And that's it. This is how you can easily attach a text in 3D space that will follow your camera movements. Remember to subscribe our channel and see you in the next tutorial. Bye.